Morning! We are currently arriving in Castaway Cay. Gary C is still in bed.
Oh, we're already here.
So why is the ship making like a little moving noise?
Oh, we're like pulling in by the looks of it. I've had it previously where I've been on a cruise where you can see the island, but actually I think I prefer facing this way because you get to like see everything happening.
Moo moo shrew. Now you've heard of Trumos, the new milk. Oh, chocolate milk, I hate that. Available from Gary C.
Not sponsored. Chocolate milk's for me anyway. Right, so we've got two cereals for the morning, so that's two bowls there. Two milks there.
Oh, for tomorrow?
For tomorrow morning.
Monsieur et Madame. Oh, you kept that quiet, that you had the little don noir.
Don noir. Hello, my lookbook today is swim shorts from Hollister, flip-flops from Havana's, and a stripy t-shirt from Crew.
Asda, Primark, keeping it real.
Also, people ask me about my pink backpack. It's literally just like the cheapest of cheap backpacks you can get from eBay. I think I paid like £6 or £7 for it. So it's like one of those ones that they would normally like print stuff on.
Oh!
How long have we been in this room?
As you were.
Good start to the day.
As you were.
Into the unknown. I love the details about how they design the ship and stuff. This little line here is the air conditioning, but you would never know that.
Is it?
Yeah. Clever, isn't it? Oh, decades more experience with Disney Vacation Club. Away we go!
Here we go.
What a ship.
Absolutely huge.
They're currently doing some window washing up there. Fun fact for you though, you see this little like key symbol here?
Yeah, on the floor.
That's to signal where the stabilizers are.
Oh.
So when they're out at sea, if a ship or a boat needs to pull alongside, they make sure not to go near the propeller, the stabilizers. Captain Jack Sparrow is out and about. Good morning.
Welcome to Captain Jack's Key. That's the name of this.
Ah, good to know. This is one of the best places to get a view of the ship and get a picture with the back. A Castaway, basically there's like a seating area over here. You just come upstairs. Very nice. I'm telling you now, in this heat in July, we are definitely taking the tram.
We are definitely taking the tram.
We've both got factor 50 on. And we still feel like we're burning.
Good morning everybody, welcome aboard the Castaway Cay shuttle. We are heading to the centre of the island. Please keep your hands and arms inside the vehicle at all times and enjoy the ride.
On the Castaway Cay tram, it basically stops once at Scuttle's Cove and then it carries on to Pelican Point. And at Pelican Point you can transfer to go to Serenity Bay. Pelican Point's closer to like the main things, so I'd recommend staying on the tram to the Pelican Point stop. We've got this whole like conched out range. I'm assuming that's like a Bahamian phrase or something.
Mine. Castaway Cay phone case.
Very nice. I've got that as a postcard from when I first came.
Did you?
Oh, who's that? Is that Mr. Styles I hear?
Mr. Styles.
What a bit of sugar, hi. 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 What a bit of sugar. Please do not leave your bag there, because it will go around the corner and it will fly off.
I was overcome with the power of Harry Styles.
So Serenity Bay is the adults only beach. The last time we came here, the beach had been washed away.
It is gone.
So we are heading there to actually have a little look, sit on the beach, get a drink. It's worth noting the tram does have a significant step up, so anyone with mobility issues, just be mindful of that. Ooh, talk about serene. My pro tip for Serenity Bay, if you do happen to be getting off the ship and want to come here, my advice is to get off A, as early as you can, and B, when you get to the beach, go as far down the beach as you possibly can, because that end is dead. Do we fancy a pina colada, maybe?
A pina colada. A non-alcoholic, freshly in
coconut, delicious waft.
There you go.
Thank you.
Cheers, Gary. To Disney Wish.
Oh, never gets old.
Thank you very much. What is he doing? The smile on your face taking that picture.
Satisfaction.
So we're walking down the beach to find a good space to sit. Literally, if you get past this lifeguard, there's no one there.
The mum is currently preparing the little bed things.
Have you got enough sun cream, Mum?
I have.
Have you got a bottle of water?
I have, you just bought it.
Okay, have you got your sun hat with you?
I do.
Good, all right. Don't stay in the sun for more than 15 minutes, but enjoy yourself, all right? I'm gonna stay here, just stay where I can see you.
All right, stay where I can see you.
I see you, Jonathan. Yes, Jonathan, very good, very good. No, I've never seen you splash before.
Children. This gives a whole new meaning to treat yourself. Look at him. And there's me in the shade where I belong, Shady Jane. Oh, hello.
Hello. Come to join us.
I have. I've just wanted to see what the water was like. Oh, it's cold. I thought it'd be warm because of the heat.
What do you think of Serenity Bay, Gary?
Serene.
Serenity.
Tranquility.
Lovely little water and the little chairs.
Lots of furniture, utility.
For those of you viewers worried about Gary being in the sun, yes, he has definitely got Flex 50 on. Also, he's only doing this for the picture and he's going to go back and sit in the shade.
You know me too well.
I do.
You know, literally the second that camera's off, I'm back there in the shade. Do not look at me, do not talk to me. This is too hot.
Hello. It's the goose. And I'm loose on Serenity Bay.
I'm amused.
You can't help yourself, can you?
I can't.
Okay. It's a bit hot now.
It's getting toasty.
I think we're done.
I got myself soaked!
Oh, for goodness sake! We've got a couple of showers here on the side that you can wash the sand off your feet. Gary had a fight with the shower, but I think the shower won.
I couldn't help myself. I have to... Like, it literally got me.
They do a barbecue on the island, but we had that previously. And today, I think it's so hot we can't bear to stomach that much food right now. So we're gonna head back to the ship, try and cool down a little bit. We're gonna see if we can get on the Aquamouse, because most people are on the island, so it should be quiet. And then we might try one of the, what do they call it? Mickey and Friends festival shack things.
Oh yeah, the little
barbecues,
the little foods
and Mexican places.
Oh, so that breeze is nice.
Oh yeah. Lovely.
Listen to me, I'm like an old girl. I'm like,
Oh, that breeze is lovely. Oh yeah, it really takes the edge off the heat. On the island, for all the Disney-owned shops, you'll just use your cruise card. However, if you want to shop in some of these Bahamian shops, you will need some US dollars. This is the family beach. Doesn't look too bad, actually. Considering that the ship holds 4,000 people, there's still plenty of space.
Quiet. Starting to be a bit more busier nearer the ship. So if you are going to get a little patch for the family, walk down a bit because it seems to thin out the further away from the ship you get.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Why are you laughing?
Oh my God, that was like out of a sitcom. So basically, when the cast members are being trained on the ship, they'll like show them around the island. So as we were coming down this path back to the ship, there was basically like the person who was training them, and then all like probably 20 cast members all in a single file line with like earning my ears badge. But the thing with cast members is obviously taught, like when you say your guest on the island, say hello. So I had hello, 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 hello. So I just started going, hello, 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 hello. They loved it. Toodaloo, castaway. Toodaloo.
Goodbye. It was a lovely visit once again.
Fun fact for you. You see the colour of the hull here? That's called Monica Blue. when the Imagineers were trying to decide what colour to paint the Disney Magic, one of the Imagineers' assistants walked in, called Monica, and she was wearing pants that were that colour, and they just decided that's the exact colour we need. So that's why it's called Monica Blue.
Nice. 7 a.m. the usual morning lineup.
Nice to see Rapunzel hanging out.
Hello and welcome to Adam's an Idiot. So, we knew that because the ship has the Aquamouse, we would want to film the Aquamouse. So, I bought a GoPro. And just before we came, I was like, okay, well, I'll wipe the SD card, blah, blah, blah. And if you have a GoPro, you have to have a micro SD card. I left the micro SD card at home.
So now we have a GoPro that is a piece of plastic.
Well, I'm going to take my phone. I don't know if they'll let us film on that. It is waterproof, but we'll see. This is the ultimate oh, Adam. The Aquamouse opens in 10 minutes. There's already a line in the outside now. No. We can't stand it for some that long. We'll see if when they open it, the line goes in.
Yeah.
Mickey and Friends Festival of Foods. Let's go and get some lunch. I went for a little bit of everything from everywhere. So I've gone for a pizza, a burrito, and a little bit of a pulled pork mac and cheese with some Disney fries.
I've gone from four, should I say, a margarita pizza and sweet potato fries for them.
And also, we're sat right here for when we're done. One thing I've noticed, they've also got like metal ramekins, so they like wash them now instead of having the plastic ones. So we had this whole strategy of we're going to come back to the ship, no one will be on there, we'll go to do the Aquamouse, la la la, the song. What do we got? What do we do? We came back and there's like a 45 minute wait.
Yeah, well, it's 1 till 10. So everybody has been waiting all morning for it to start up. So there's a massive line and it doesn't, it would be fine if it was just the inner bit, but it went all down the stairs and all onto the deck.
Yeah.
Which,
and in the heat, it's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It's not safe to do that in this heat. So we'll chill in here for a bit, cool down. We've been in the heat a lot. We just need to kind of make sure that we're hydrated and, you know, not take too many risks or anything. And then we'll check it again. But yeah, so I'm pretty sure that on the Dream and the Fantasy, that the aqueduct would be open during the day. But I don't know. To kill some time, we're going to pop up to the Inside Out sweet treats place and go and get some ice cream or something.
Red velvet.
The one scoop was $3.75 and each topping was 60 cents. Gelato and Beauty and the Beast.
What more could you want in life? I mean, this is it for me.
Aquamouse take two!
Woo!
Here we go.
Don't know why I'm excited. I'm usually terrified of these things.
It's because you want to check it off your list.
Because I want the pin.
Never mind, the line's even longer now and it's broken. So we'll come back another time. We think we might try and do it. We're going to go to the matinee of Little Mermaid. They're doing that on this sailing because it's a relatively new show, new ship. They're doing a matinee showing at 3 p.m. So we're going to go to that. And hopefully at the time that we would normally be going to see the show, when everything's a bit quieter, we could probably do it then. We have got the bits and bobs to do our tipping now. They basically give you two pieces of paper in order to put in your automatic gratuities, which are the ones that, like, Disney Cruise Line charge you automatically, and then they give you a little envelope that you can put those in as well as anything extra. Everyone has been amazing.
Yeah, everyone that's sort of tended to us, and
The server and the assistant server have probably been the best servers I've had.
Yeah, I love any of the Disney Cruises. Boot and stuff.
Oh yeah, Javier, we love Javier. Yeah. Where are we off to, Gary C?
We're going to the Little Mermaid matinee show, so we're leaving early to get some nice chairs.
What? You look like a teacher.
I'm telling you.
A naughty teacher as well. No, the other kind of naughty.
Oh, ow.
It's weird how like how accurate it looks to this like the CGI render they did.
It looks almost exactly the same.
Fancy shop, fancy shop.
They are everywhere. Where you buy stuff, get indebted, and then so stressed you lose your hair.
Needs work.
It needs work. We'll workshop work. That. Get back to you.
Well, we thought go. The matinee would be quiet.
We thought.
Any use of photography and audio or video recording devices is strictly prohibited.
Just as Ursula was emerging from the waters, the waters stopped moving, and unfortunately we had a show stop, and it doesn't look like the show's going to come back up. So no. We might try again later to see if it's up and running, but it's a new show on a new ship. There's bound to be technical difficulties. So thankfully we saw the matinee, saw half of it at least. So we'll sneak into the 6:30 show in later, I think.
Untangled Salon. Ooh.
We interrupt this broadcast because I forgot to tell you what we're doing. We are going to go and get a fire and ice pedicure. This is Gary's very first sort of spa salon type appointment. It took some real convincing to get him to try this, so let's see what he thinks.
Wow, this is beautiful.
Does your stress affect you negatively in any of the following ways? Digestion? Yes. Muscle tension? Yes. Skin? Yes. Sleep? Yes. I mean, when you have anxiety disorder, panic attacks and depression, I think I'm ticking everything.
I've just started playing this music. I'm very excited because this is music for Planet Coaster, which is one of my favourite computer games. I feel like I'm in build mode. You enjoying your seat massage? Buzzing away.
Were you running to get here?
No. We went to do the Aquamouse.
So Gary, how are your feet feeling?
Very soft, very refreshed. My muscles that cause a lot of pain have all been massaged and everything, so I've got new legs. We'll see how long these legs last.
I mean, you were quite anxious coming into this. So what?
I was very anxious for a while, and then the salt scrub just like stripped me. I wanted something that's like the smell, because I'm someone that reacts to smells, and the smell was so like that was relaxing. So I was like,
well, they were just the two nicest cast members ever.
Yeah, they were great. We should put a cast compliment thing for them.
Yeah, so when they do the turndown service this evening, you get a comment card, and on that, if you write a cast member's name, normally they'll get like a little kickback. We're now going to be travelling to Star Wars Hyperspace Lounge. This is the reservation we managed to get at the start of the cruise. We feel like we've had like... We've had lots of appointments that are like literally back to back, so we're looking forward to this thing. Libation free, cocktails, wine selections, galaxy brews. I'm assuming we're going to go for libation free. They've got a Cloud City, which is oat milk, blue raspberry, galaxy ice cream. Or they've got a Temple Twist, which is apple, mint, pineapple, ginger beer, and kiwi. I might try that.
I'll try the Cloud City.
Cool in here, isn't it?
Oh, I love it.
Okay, so we've both gone for non-alcoholic options. We've got one of each that's available. I've got the something something twist, and you've got the
something twist, and I got the something cloud.
Cheers to Star Wars.
Oh, wow.
It's very gingery.
Is it? You like it?
Which do you prefer?
That one. This one is very
It's got like a kick to it.
So on deck three, they've got a range of luxury retail. So we're going to pop into, is it Three Wishes?
Three Wishes.
Yeah, very nice.
Which are Three Wishes?
Luxury watches. You're looking for those? Then there's Once Upon a Time next door, which is essentially the same shop. That does fancy watches, that does fancy watches. There's also Royal Regalia, which looks like more feminine watches and some handbags. And then over the other side, we've got Treasures Untold. Those of you that love Dooney and Burke, this is the shop for you. They've got a selection of Disney Cruise Line ones here. How much is this? This is $248. This one here is $298. And they've got a Wish collection, which looks very nice. This store also sells perfume and colognes. Very nice. Also got some clothing items here that are probably going to be branded. They've got a coaster set here, which is $34.99. I really like that. They've also got a Christmas ornament there for $34.99. And a tote bag down here for $44.99.
I'm always frightened of these. They feel so fragile. And yet here I am holding
it. Yeah, why are you touching it then?
I thought then to myself.
They've got these inaugural sailings
snow globes.
I did debate adding this to the competition prize that we did for the last vlog, but that is just a liability trying to get that home. Okay, you shaking things that are made of glass just gives me a level of anxiety.
$64.99.
I mean, for a nice... People collect those, don't they?
Well, I used to. It was, which is no surprise to the viewers. But yeah, that is a lovely one. Very heavy.
I love the ship model. This one is $499. And then there's a smaller one here, which I believe is like 50-something? $49.99. Look at me! I love this print, it's very nice.
Mm.
How much is that? That's $55. Hmm, I'd get that.
It's a lovely colour.
The Disney and Coach collection.
I like the bag.
How much is the bag?
Don't know, but it's really heavy, I think.
This one's $595. The embroidery is quite nice.
This isn't Gary C money, this is $595.
Okay, stop touching it. We are now heading to the Little Mermaid Take Two.
Let's go for round two.
So, it stopped again. And at pretty much the same point. So, we may never see the Little Mermaid after all.
Yeah.
We did get past
Poor Unfortunate Souls. We've seen that.
Oh, curtain up. All right, back. See you later.
You can sit down.
Oh, I think we should sit down. We have walked from the theatre to here in silence. I was really disappointed. Considering that is the flagship show of this ship, I was disappointed, honestly.
The first half is a lot stronger than the second half.
It's almost like fate was saying, you've seen all the good bits, you can go now.
You've seen the good.
Like, the cast had the talent there.
The cast were great. The puppetry idea was brilliant.
Yeah.
I actually forgot there was a puppeteer for Sebastian because the
and
guy...
And Sebastian was the flawless.
Voice, the voice is on the sisters, the daughters of Triton.
Yes, really good.
And Sebastian, incredible.
Based on what we've seen... We haven't seen Aladdin, but maybe Aladdin's meant to be the flagship one. I don't know. That's still in rehearsals at the moment. But... The Seize the Adventure was a 5+.
Oh, Seize the Adventure, which is
loved it,
which is usually seen as like the B show to the big Disney show.
But, well, that's normally the C show.
Yeah, and it was incredible.
That was amazing.
Oh, it's heartbreaking to say it, but 3.
I would go 2. So,
anyway,
hopefully they work on it.
What's the next one? Pushed.
God, that was
my finest work.
I absolutely love this space. This is as well themed as the Rapunzel Restaurant of the Magic.
Oh, this is beautiful.
The backs of the chairs have different seasons on them. How good is that? What have I got? I've got winter! So, on the Arendelle menu tonight, we have a few starters to choose from. We've got a s'mores board by the looks of it. Got a asparagus dish, scallops, and a tart.
Entrees, we've got a pork tenderloin, a sea bass, some sort of, I can't pronounce that, chicken breast and ribeye steak. What are you going to have, Gary?
For the smoker's board, I'm going to have Elsa's Royal Baked Scallop, which is shrimp, rainbow carrots, leek, and pastry.
Pastry?
Pastry.
Pastry.
Love the costume.
You came on a great day. Today is Kristoff and Anna's engagement party. But you probably already knew that.
That is why they are here, no?
Yeah.
Right. Hands down, this is the best engagement party ever.
Ooh, thank you very much.
I mean, I think it is. This is my first engagement party. I've never been engaged before. Come on, let's go celebrate more love.
Bye-bye, family.
Bye.
See you at your next engagement party.
You look so wonderful in your regalia.
Well, we have to dress up for the party.
You're very nice.
I'm getting used to castle attire myself. So.
How's it being queen?
Oh, I love it. I think Elsa and I are both going to be meant
to be. Oh, good.
Sven's carrot soup for Gary. I've actually got that coming after my starter, which is the tart.
Oh, very nice. And I'm not talking about that tart over there.
Say, did someone say tart?
This has got to be the best carrot soup I've ever had.
This tart is amazing. 5 out of 5. This has been my favourite food already.
Yeah, this is beautiful.
Yeah, very nice.
The production value is 10 out of 10. I'm never going back. The best is in their pants. I went for the sea bass, and Gary has gone for the crusted chicken.
I went for the Queen Iduna's Latife or something. Queen Iduna's leafy shenanigans.
Oh, Gary's got to get a picture.
Elsa, this is incredible. I think we
illustrations and stuff on these menus. The one for the Marvel one was great as well. 1928, they all had like specific to the theme, like perfection.
What's the matter, Gary? You got two mouths.
I might as well. I've done enough chat. Right, I need to read out what they are first before we do the taste test.
Okay, I've gone for the Caefjord cake. Our server also brought the chocolate bar speciality dessert, and that's the...
Right, so this is the citrus almond cake, no sugar added. Oh, get out. No one wants that. And then this is the Epley cake, apple cake. So it's like caramel sauce, vanilla bean ice cream, Florentine almond.
Right,
apple.
So you don't like apples and you don't like things without sugar, so you've got two things that are apple and no sugar.
For the viewers.
I've got a little throne you can sit on here. We've got the busts over there. Very cool restaurant. On this long corridor, make sure you stop and look at all the art, because there's like little hidden characters and stuff. It's very lovely. But you can understand why the corridor's so long when you're coming into dining. One. I think this is my favourite one as well. Oh, I don't know. 1923 was pretty good. Little dog. We just got back from Arendelle. Thoughts?
Arendelle. 5 out of 5. Look at me, Lady Muck, sitting here with my chocolate.
Lady Muck. No, 5 out of 5. The food was amazing. Entertainment was amazing. Well, out of the three, what was your favourite?
1923.
Agreed.
But Arendelle, the singer in there, the girl that does the story of... Oh, I just can't.
Yeah, no, it was amazing. So we both said 5 out of 5 for Arendelle. Mm-hmm. We've had an amazing time. We love the ship. It's beautiful. We've been really comfortable in the stateroom. The bathroom's amazing. The crew have been outstanding. It's like Disney chose the best of the best to work on the ship. Mm-hmm. So we've had special mentions to Inuman and Javier, our servers. We've got Ruth, who was our stateroom host. Sophie, who we met around the ship, who helped us find the art, she was outstanding, and Fairy Godmother's Apprentice, Ella, and also Ash from the entertainment team.
From entertainment that helped us with bits of knowledge about things to do and things like that.
Yeah, so great. We've honestly had the best time, and I mean, I think we've mentioned the things that we think could be improved.
Yeah, but they're not life-changing things.
No, and they probably... We've spoken to other guests and they've had the same things. Like, there's a couple of layout things that could probably change on the ships and stuff. But if you were taking a Disney cruise for the very first time and you were coming on the Disney Wish, we think you'd have a great time.
An amazing time. And you'll probably compare other ships, other cruise brands lines to it. And the Wish is just magical. Especially, like, the story of, like, wishing and magic and enchantment as you get on. Just great.
Yeah, that's great. Well... In the meantime, we will be signing off for this evening, and it's the end of the Disney Cruise Line portion of the vlog series. However, we have something very exciting to tell you. This isn't the end. We're going to Disney World.
I don't have any confetti, but I'll just use the wrappers from the chocolate.
Okay. We are spending 3 nights at the Grand Floridian.
Pyro.
Production value, 10 out of 10. So, fun story. We actually had the Grand Floridian booked for the 50th anniversary. Mm-hmm. But obviously, due to COVID, that got cancelled and everything like that. So we've been like in the back of our head thinking like, oh, we still really want to stay at the Grand Floridian. And so for 3 nights, we thought, let's go club level.
A special little club level magical moment, and just to have a look around and just get the vibe. So
And on 3 nights... You know, you can kind of justify it a little bit
also,
more.
Also, who wants to fly 4,000 odd miles across the sea for like 3 days, whatever it was?
Like, yeah, we thought we did need some Disney World time. So, we're going to try and get on Cosmic Rewind. We're going to try and do some of the fireworks shows, a little bit of Food and Wine Festival maybe. Mm. So don't forget to subscribe, tune into some more Disney World, and we'll see you in next week's video. So, in the meantime, like this video if you enjoyed it, subscribe to see all the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time!